Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. In a hadith collected by Imam Bukhari and Muslim, Abu Hurairah radiallahu anhu is reported to have said that the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said that no salah is more burdensome to the hypocrites than the Fajr salah and the Isha prayer. If they knew their merits, they would have come for it or come to it, even if they had to crawl. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, no salah is more difficult to these hypocrites than the Fajr salah and the Isha prayer. Should they know the merits, the importance, and the reward of performing salah, the Fajr salah and the Isha salah, the hypocrites would even crawl in order not to miss out. So brothers and sisters, what the Prophet is reminding us here is about the importance of performing Fajr Salah, more so for the main folk in Jama'ah at the mosque, when you have a mosque closer to you. Or the women folk, of course, praying at home, but praying on time. Because Allah said in Surah Nisa, Inna salata kanat ala al-mu'minina kitaban mawquta. The prayers is enjoined upon the believers on fixed times, on stipulated times. No wonder the Prophet said that should the hypocrites know the importance of performing Fajr Salah on time and Isha Salah on time, they would even crawl to the masjid, or they would even crawl and perform this prayer in order not to miss out on the rewards and benefits. But then again, this is a reminder that every salah should be performed on time. Like I said, Allah said, salah is stipulated, is prescribed or enjoined upon the believers on fixed times. And of course, brothers and sisters, no one wants to be a hypocrite. No one wants to be a hypocrite. So if at all waking up for Fajr, performing salah on time for Fajr, is always difficult for you, then you need to ask yourself, where do I stand with hypocrisy? Why am I missing out on my prayers? Why am I not praying Isha? When I call myself a Muslim, I'm missing out on Fajr. I don't pray Fajr on time. I don't pray Isha on time. I still call myself a Muslim. And the Prophet said Fajr and Isha is difficult for the hypocrite. So let's sacrifice, make efforts, and let's commit ourselves to performing salam on time with sincerity and devotion. All these five daily prayers, but more so Fajr. Why Fajr and Isha? Because that is the time when you don't even have the opportunity to show off. People might be sleeping, and that's the time when real sincerity clicks in, because rising up without anyone seeing you just to please Allah entails sincerity in every aspect of the world. So brothers and sisters, we don't want to be hypocrites. And about the hypocrites, Allah said, Innal munafiqina fi darkil asfali minan nar. They form the base of Jahannam. The hypocrites, we don't want to be one of them. Among the signs of hypocrisy, if the person talks, he lies. If he promises, he fails. If there's a covenant between you and the hypocrite, he always fails that covenant. He proves treacherous. Among the signs of hypocrisy, if he or she is engaged in an argument, he goes beyond the limit. We don't want these qualities in our lives. But then part of hypocrisy is always missing out on Fajr and Isha on time if you call yourself a Muslim. May Allah make it easy for all of us, inshallah, to perform all the five daily prayers on time with sincerity and devotion, inshallah. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.